The cop who shot and killed someone over sunglasses has now been fired. Let me first do this. I want to bring you the video, then I have the background. Here it is.
I got the radio. Urban 2 holding channel for us. Bloomingdale flat lot. Black male going towards 7 from Fashion. He's crossing over. Crossing over, guys. Get on the ground. Get on the ground. Going into the woods. Through the woods. Get on the ground. Get on the ground. Stop reaching. Stop reaching.
Put up the picture full mask, the victim of this insanity. Timothy Johnson. This is an update to a story we brought you last month. Last month, a Fairfax County police fatally shot a black man believed to be shoplifting. Now, one of the officers has been fired. Officers suspected the man who was killed, Timothy Johnson, 37, has stolen items from a Tysons Corner shopping center on the 22nd of February. Chief Kevin Davis told reporters, according to a department news release, Sergeant Wesley Shifflett, a 7-year veteran of the department, and police officer first class James Sattler, an 8-year veteran of the department, discharged their firearms. Police said the two officers fired 3 total shots. And Davis confirmed Shifflett fired the fatal shot. Officers' actions do not meet the expectations of our department, in particular, use of force policies, protocols, and procedures, Davis says. He will no longer be a Fairfax County police officer. Let's put up the chief. So, Chief, why is he not arrested? I don't understand. You clearly see there's no reason for a man to be dead. You clearly say that in your own proclamation about what happened. This is the most impactful negative thing a person can do. Take another life. A press release posted after the shooting by the FCPD detailed what happened that day. An officer observed the man exiting the store near a parking garage. As he exited the store, the anti-theft alarm was activated as he fled. It read, Shifflett was in uniform, but Sattler was working undercover in plain clothes when they started chasing Johnson on foot into a nearby wooded area. Let's put his picture up. Johnson's mother and the family's attorney, Carl Cruz, says the way he was killed could be considered an execution, and I agree. The best way to describe the video is to say what was not on it, what it doesn't show, danger. It doesn't show the officers faced any danger, imminent or otherwise, Cruz says. The department declared this is not the way it runs. Since his termination, Officer Shifflett has acquired legal representation. His lawyer, Caleb Kushner, says his client was acting in self-defense at the time of the shooting. According to Shifflett, his lawyer claims the suspect was not obeying any of the officer commands directed at him. He and Sattler believed Johnson to have posed to them a serious threat, leaving their lives in jeopardy, he says. A police officer should never be forced to be shot or seriously injured before he takes actions to protect himself or others, the attorney said. You know, this is going to bite this attorney, because a good prosecutor is going to utilize your statement, sir, and ask you, why did you not present specific details when you made the proclamation about your client? What was it that the victim did which made them feel as if they were in imminent danger. You left that part out. Why? Because you have no justification. You have no narrative. You have no evidence. You have no truth. Okay. Unarmed man, black male, shot and killed. Posed no threat, no danger, nothing. Watch any thoughts here.
I'm always struck by this stuff, specifically when these guys are in quote unquote hot pursuit of a quote unquote suspect, like what the crime being alleged is. This is not some dude fleeing a murder spree or, you know, he held somebody captive like you've seen on the movies, and they're just in hot pursuit of this extremely obviously dangerous criminal, right? Allegedly, the guy that they thought they were chasing after had shoplifted. This is just crazy. like the idea that these guys would carry themselves this way in pursuit of a potential shoplifter, right? And that this can turn deadly over shoplifting at a convenience store. That's the part that kind of kills me more than anything. That these officers think that their job is to potentially kill, murder a shoplifter. That's the saddest part of all of this to me. Just the casual violence associated with a crime as innocuous and unimportant as shoplifting.
The slave patrol was really the first official permeation of law enforcement in America. They were given a particular authority, the authority to obviously kill or physically restrict and move those who were enslaved. But their primary job was actually protecting property. Property, okay? When you think about what just happened, and I'm talking to cops all across this country, shoplifting from a store. Who made those glasses? Likely a multi-million dollar company. Who distributes the sunglasses? A multi-million dollar company. How much do you get paid, officer? Do you get paid millions of dollars to protect the million dollar companies that produce the product that you are about to kill a man over? No. Why have you been programmed to believe this is even worthy of you chasing somebody? I'd be damned if I chase somebody for sunglasses. I don't care what kind of job I have. A man's life is gone. Just because somebody may need to see a judge does not mean they're supposed to see their maker. You are not judge, jury, and executioner.